I sang for the then governor of Arkansas at a fundraiser in California last September, he told me what his favorite song was of mine, and I said, well, I'm not singing it tonight, but I'll tell you what, I'll sing it at your inauguration. I am so happy to say here we are. This is a promise I'm delighted to keep. This is for you and Mrs. Clinton. Long ago, I was putting my four-year-old goddaughter to sleep, and I started to sing her a lullaby. Rock-a-bye, baby, on the treetop. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. When the bough breaks, the cradle will fall. The cradle will fall? I mean, was I supposed to tell her, down will come baby, cradle and all? What a frightening thought in a song that's been sung to children for hundreds of years to soothe them before they go to sleep, right? I started to think about the fairy tales that we read children, you know, like Take Hansel and Gretel. where a mother worried about how she and her husband will feed their children in the midst of a famine. And she says, early tomorrow morning, we will take them into the thickest part of the forest. They won't be able to find their way home, and we'll be rid of them. Talk about a dysfunctional family. Talk about rejection and abandonment. What does this say to children? What do parents say to children that sends them into the woods without them ever leaving home? Things like, you're a nuisance, you're a sissy, it's all your fault. Careful the things you say, children will listen. Careful the things you do, children will see and learn. Children may not obey, but children will listen. Children will look to you for which way to turn, to learn what to be. Careful before you say, listen to me. Children, careful the path they take, wishes come true, not free. Careful the spell you cast, not just on children. Sometimes the spell may last past what you can see and turn against thee. That is the spell. Children will listen. We cannot abuse children, either by word or by deed, because what's done to them, they will do to society. But if we give them the love and respect they deserve and educate them properly, we as a nation will be enriched. We must put children first. And we are so fortunate to have a First Lady who has fought for and will continue to fight for the rights of children. Because she knows that we hold tomorrow in our hands when we hold our children in our arms. So guide them, but step away. Children will glisten. Children will look to you for which way to turn, to learn what to be. Careful before you say, listen to me. Children will listen. Children. I'm a little hoarse tonight, you have to forgive me, but thank God the president-elect has made it fashionable. I have some tea for you here. With honey, no lemon. I know that grace is something said before a meal, but I feel that America has a great feast before it, and so perhaps a grace of sorts is appropriate. I'm thankful for the blessings bestowed upon us, the richness and beauty of our land, the diversity of our people, and especially for the new leadership, which will take us forward to a time of hope and healing. I'm thankful for our new vice president. Because in your hands, I know the planet will have a true and devoted caretaker. And I am so grateful for our new president, who carries the burdens of our expectations in this unsettled world. The tasks are overwhelming, but you inspire in us a confidence and trust, a positive sense of the future that is new and wonderful. I pray for your health, your stamina, and your joy in the work that lies before you. We are, all of us, truly blessed. While the storm clouds gather, far across the sea, let us swear allegiance to a land that's free. Let us all be grateful for a land so fair, as we raise our voices in a solemn prayer. It is my honor and great pleasure to introduce to you the 42nd President of the United States, Bill Clinton.
Thank you.